We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Prompt our actions with your inspiration, we pray, O Lord, and further them with your constant help, that all we do may always begin from you, and by you be brought to completion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Today I have set before you life and prosperity, death and doom. If you obey the commandments of the Lord your God, which I enjoin on you today, loving him and walking in his ways, and keeping his commandments, his statutes and decrees, you will live and grow numerous, and the Lord your God will bless you in the land you are entering to occupy. If, however, you turn away your hearts and will not listen, but are led astray and adore and serve other gods, I tell you now that you will certainly perish. You will not have a long life on the land that you are crossing the Jordan to enter and occupy. I call heaven and earth today to witness against you. I have set before you life and death, the blessing and the curse. Choose life then, that you and your descendants may live by loving the Lord your God, heeding his voice and holding fast to him, for that will mean life for you, a long life for you to live on the land that the Lord swore he would give to the fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walk in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his way low day and night.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Not so wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the winds drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, by the way of the wicked vanishes.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Please stand.
Repent, says the Lord, the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The Son of Man must suffer greatly and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests and the scribes, and be killed, on the third day be raised. Then he said to all, if anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will save it. What profit is there for man who gain the whole world, yet lose or forfeit his himself? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Alam niyo po, hindi natin kayang bilhin ang pagmamahal. Pero kapag nagmamahal ka, kailangan mo magbayad. Hindi mo kayang bilhin ang pagmamahal, pero pag nagmahal ka, kailangan mo magbayad. Diba, hindi naman natin kailangan umapilit ang ibang tao na mahalin ka. Pero kung ikaw ay nagmamahal, ay binibigay ka oras mo, talino mo, lahat ng meron ka, lahat ng kaya mong gawin, ibibigay mo. At ganoon din ang ginawa ng ating Panginoon na si Jesus. Habang kinakausap ni Jesus ang kanyang mga alagad, ang kanyang mga disipulos sa tagpong ito, sila ay papunta na sa Jerusalem. At sinasabi na niya doon kung ano mangyayari sa kanya, na kailangan siyang magdusa at mamamatay siya. Pero sa ikatlong araw, mababuhay siyang muli. At yun po ang kabayaran ng kanyang pagmamahal. He has to suffer. He has to be killed. At kung sino man ang gustong sumunod sa kanya, tinuturuan niya ang kanyang mga disipulos. Kung gusto mong sumunod sa akin, you have to imitate me. You have to love like I do. At paano yun? Sabi niya, take up your cross daily and follow me. Kasi kapag nagmamahal ka, sometimes you have to say no to yourself. Kailangan mong humindi sa sarili mo. Ano yung mga hinihindian mo? May minamahal na ako. Hindi na pwedeng magmahal pa ng iba. Hindi ko na pwedeng gawin kung anong ginagawa ko nung ako'y binata o dalaga pa. May anak na ako. Hindi ko na pwedeng gastusin ang sarili kong pera sa anumang bagay. I have to deny myself in order for me to say yes to the one I love. And that is the meaning of denying yourself and picking up your cross. Kailangan mong humindi sa sarili mo. Deny yourself. Kailangan mong magsakripisyo. You pick up your cross. Dahil ganun ang pagmamahal ng Diyos. Ganun siya nagmahal. Everyday life. Hindi man siguro to the point na wala nang matitira sa sarili mo. But you have to deny most of the time to say yes for your beloved. Hindi nga, ganun din ang ginawa ni Jesus. Kaya't ganun tayo, kaibig-ibig. Ganun tayo kamahal. To the point of suffering. To the point of death. Kaya ikaw, tayong lahat, bayad tayo. Hindi man tayo nabili, pero binayaran na tayo. May ibinigay sa atin. Ano yun? Ang mismong buhay ng ating Panginoon. He gave Himself for all of us. At yun po ang pagmamahal na itinuturo ng ating Diyos, na kapag ikaw magmahal ka, you have to give yourself. You have to give yourself ng buo sa minamahal mo, sa pamilya mo, sa kung anong ginagawa mo. Kailangan mong ibigay ng buo. Kahit nahihirapan ka. Dahil mabigat naman talaga pasanin ng krus. Bakit? Magtatanong ka, bakit? Bakit mo gagawin yun kung mahirap? Bakit mo gagawin yun kung hindi naman para sa'yo? Wala ka naman palang makukuha? Meron. Meron kang makukuha. Dahil anong sinabi ni San Pablo? Sa kanyang mga sulat na sinabi ni Jesus, if you suffer with Him, you will live with Him. And if you die with Him, you will be glorified with Him. Sabi pa nga dito sa ating Ebanghelyo, for whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will save it. Bakit? Dahil sa pagmamahal, matutunan mo kung paano tunay na mabuhay. Kapag nagmamahal ka, hindi lang ito para sa'yo. Hindi ka nabubuhay para sa sarili mo. But because of the one you love, mas matutunan mo kung paano mabuhay. Kapag tunay kang nagmamahal, matututo ka kung paano mabubuhay. Na hindi mo pala kailangan ng maraming bagay. Na hindi mo pala kailangan na subsubin ang lahat ng oras mo, ng pagod mo sa trabaho. Dahil mayroong mas mahalaga. Makikita mo ang tunay na kahalagahan ng buhay, ng pag-ibig. Kaya't ang daan ni Jesus ay ang daan ng buhay. Kahit na ngayon, kailangan mong magdusa. Pero that is the paradox. Ang pagdurusa na kasama siya ay magbibigay sa iyo ng tunay na kaligayahan, ng tunay na buhay. You have to deny yourself by saying no to yourself. In order for you to say yes to the one you love. You have to pick up your cross. You have to sacrifice. Dahil ang daan ni Jesus ay ang daan ng buhay. If we suffer with Him, we will live with Him. And if we die with Him, we will be glorified with Him. Please stand. Our Lord Jesus calls us to follow him, to carry the cross after him, and to entrust to him all those who suffer. For every petition we shall answer, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer, that as members of the Church, we may imbibe in our lives the spirit of the cross and be willing to suffer for the sake of Christ and the Gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of our country may hear the cries of suffering people and may show commitment to the eradication of oppression and exploitation in society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are suffering, the poor, the sick, the handicapped, and prisoners may never fall into despair, but experience the comfort of God's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are alone in life may find companions who are willing to help them bear their crosses. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead may be one with God and their loved ones in heaven for all eternity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for our personal intentions, the intentions of this Mass, for all those whom we promise to pray, and the intentions of the devotees and pilgrims of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary of Manaoag. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, the passion and death of your Son brought life to the world. Help us to recognize the crosses and sufferings, not just in great trials of life, but in day-to-day choices. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
In the mystery of this water and wine, we come to share the divinity of Christ and the salvation of our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
The spirit and contrite heart may be accepted by you, Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing.
Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Regard with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings we set upon this sacred altar, that bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honor to your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for their renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may also deal with the things of this passing world, as to hold rather to the things that eternally endures. And so with angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Socrates our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Please stand.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe to eternal life.
Please kneel.
Let us pray that the forthcoming elections may truly reflect the will of the Lord, who guides the destinies of nations. Let us pray together. Deliver us, Lord.
Deliver us, Lord.
From coercion, violence, and terrorism.
Deliver us, Lord.
From dishonesty, lies, and all distortion of truth.
Deliver us, Lord.
From bribery, graft, and all conspiracy for fraud.
Deliver us, Lord.
From threats, intimidation, and perverse language.
Deliver us, Lord.
Let us pray together. Hear us, Lord.
Hear us, Lord.
That conscience may always be our ultimate norm.
Hear us, Lord.
That the common good may always be our highest goal.
Hear us, Lord.
That human dignity may be respected all the time.
Hear us, Lord.
That the poor and the weak may always have the priority.
Hear us, Lord.
That genuine fear of God and love of neighbors may guide those who seek public office.
Hear us, Lord.
Let us pray. Shepherd of souls and Savior of the nations, politics is your gift to us, a call to serve others. May our political engagement for voters and candidates bring glory to your loving name and help us grow in holiness forever and ever.
Amen. Please stand.
Let us pray. Having received the blessing of your heavenly gifts, we humbly beseech you, Almighty God, that they may always be for us a source both of pardon and of salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the announcement. Brothers and sisters, you are cordially invited to come to the following services of the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. Confession, Monday to Friday, from 7:30 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. at the Paschal Chapel. Praying of the Reparation Rosary for Truth, Integrity, and Wisdom, from Monday to Saturday at 5:40 a.m. Exposition of the Blessed Sacrament and Benediction, integrated with the Office of Readings and Evening Prayer, every Wednesday from 5:30 p.m. to 6:45 p.m. Stations of the Cross every Friday from 3:30 to 4:30 p.m. Thank you. Please stand.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikiisa sa banal na misa. Patuloy po nating ipagdasal ang bawat isa. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow down for the blessing. Almighty God, who have made known to your people the ways of eternal life, lead them by the path, we pray to you, the unfading light, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit come down in you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer for the blessing of the sick. God, our Almighty Father, by your blessing, you give us strength and support in our frailty. Turn with kindness toward our sick brothers and sisters. Free them from all illness and restore them to good health through the intercession of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, so that, in the sure knowledge of your goodness, they will gratefully bless your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer for the blessing of rosaries and other religious articles. In memory of the mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the honor and glory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Christ, Mother of the Church, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, may these rosaries, candles, oils, and images, and other religious articles be blessed and be made holy in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.